Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kandan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Internal Combustion Engine. This is lecture number 12. The topic is Lubrication System. And we recap from the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we studied about the combustion in an IC engine and the cooling system in the IC engine. And in the combustion, we studied about the combustion chamber, the flame front propagation, how the combustion is happening, and what is the rate of heat release during the combustion process. And in the cooling system, we studied about the necessity for cooling, water cooling system, and the air cooling system used in the IC engine. And in this topic, lubrication system, we are going to study about the functions of lubrication system: mist lubrication, wet sump lubrication, dry sump lubrication, and properties of lubricants and additives. So it is another important system in the IC engine for its smooth function. And the learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to describe the functions of lubrication system, explain the wet sump lubrication system, discuss the properties of lubricants, and state the need for additives in the lubricants. So, lubrication system. Lubrication is an art of admitting a lubricant, normally oil, lubricating oil, and grease between two surfaces that are in contact and in relative motion. In IC engine, so there are metal surfaces in contact and they have relative motion, like piston cylinder. So piston is reciprocating inside the cylinder, so there is metal to metal contact between piston and the cylinder. And we have the all mechanism, so you have the linking mechanism, so connecting rod connected to the piston, connecting rod connected to the crankshaft, and the various mechanical surface, contact surface are available, and we have relative motions between the component. The purpose of the lubrication in an IC, in an engine, is to perform one or several of the following functions. We have certain functions. The purpose or the functions of the lubrication system. The first function or the main or primary function is to reduce the friction and the wear between the moving parts, and thereby the energy loss, and to increase the life of the engine. So we have to reduce the friction wear so that we are reducing the energy loss in the engine and increase the life of the engine. That is the primary purpose of any lubrication. Primary purpose is to reduce the friction and wear between the moving parts, and thereby energy loss. So we reduce the energy loss and to increase the life of the engine. In addition to that, so the lubrication system is to provide sealing action. So, the lubricating oil helps the piston rings and maintain an effective seal against the high pressure gases in the cylinder from leaking out into the crankcase. So, we have the piston rings at the top of the piston, we have the piston rings. So, in the piston rings, we have a layer of lubricating oil. So, on the top crown surface and the piston ring, we have the layer of lubricating oil, and the lubricating oil will cover the piston rings, and it will act as a seal. So because of the sealing action, so the exhaust gas, I mean the burnt gases inside the combustion chamber, they will not leak into the crankcase. So that is the first action. It will provide a seal on the surface of the piston rings, so that the burnt gases, high temperature, high pressure gases in the cylinder, right, will not leak into the crankcase. To cool the surfaces by carrying away heat generated the engine components. So the lubricating oil is circulated to various components in the engine cylinder, crankcase, and the valve actuating mechanism. All these components are heated because of the heat produced in the engine. So the lubricating oil will pick up the heat energy and remove the heat energy, and the oil is then cooled in the crankcase. So it will act as a cooling agent. The lubricating oil, as it is circulated through the various components, various mechanism in the IC engine, so it will act as a coolant for removing the heat energy. And to clean the surface, So to clean the surfaces by washing away the carbon and the metal particle caused by the wear. So there is wear occurs because of the relative motion between two metal surfaces. There is wear, and due to the wear there will be carbon and the metal particles. So these particle will be removed by the oil. As the oil is flowing over the surface, these particles are washed away and they are collected back into the crankcase of the engine. So the primary function is reducing friction and the wear, and the other functions are provide sealing action, cool the surface, and to clean the surface. These are all the other functions of the lubricating system, lubrication system. Lubrication of engine components. So in a reciprocating engine, there are many surfaces in contact with each other, and therefore they should be lubricated to reduce the friction. So these are all the components: piston and cylinder, crankshaft and their bearing, crank pin and their bearing, wrist pin and their bearing, and valve gear. So piston and the cylinder, so we know that there is a contact, the piston is reciprocating inside the cylinder. Crankshaft and the bearing, there are two end bearing in the crankshaft, crank pin and the bearing. So the connecting rod, crank pin and the connecting rod is connected with the crank pin, and the wrist pin, it is in the top of the connecting rod, which is connecting the connecting rod and the piston. So crank pin, wrist pin, and valve gear. So we have gear mechanism for the valve actuating mechanism. So in all the valve actuating gears, so we require the lubrication. There is relative motion between the surfaces, and we require the lubrication. So lubrication is required for piston and the cylinder, crankcase and the bearing, crank pin and the bearing, wrist pin and the bearing, and the valve gears. Lubrication system. The function of the lubrication system is to provide sufficient quantity of cool filtered oil to give positive and adequate lubrication to all the moving parts of the engine. So the sufficient quantity of cooled and filtered oil to give a positive and adequate lubrication to all the moving parts of the engine. That is what the function of any lubrication system. And this lubrication system, there are three types. The various lubrication system used for internal combustion engine may be classified as mist lubrication system, wet sump lubrication system, and dry sump lubrication system. So we will discuss one by one. So here mist is very simple. It is used in the mopeds, and wet sump lubrication system, it is used in the automobile, and dry sump lubrication is also used in the automobiles. So in the mist lubrication system, normally when the crankcase lubrication is not possible, so we are using the mist lubrication system, particularly in the case of mopeds. So in the case of mopeds, when you fill the fuel tank, so we add the oil. So 30% oil is added along with the fuel, along with the petrol, and the oil, lubricating oil and the petrol is mixed with the fuel, and it is filled in the fuel tank. When the fuel is going to the carburetor, it is going along with the oil, and the oil, the fuel petrol and the oil, they are mixing with the air, and the air fuel mixer along with the lubricating oil, it will enter into the combustion chamber, where the lubricating oil are sticking onto the cylinder surface for lubrication and the piston surface for lubrication. This is what called as mist lubrication, where the lubricating oil, 3 to 6% of lubricating oil is mixed with the fuel. The advantage of the system is simplicity and low cost, as it does not require an oil pump and the filter. Very simple method, but there are some disadvantages. So the first disadvantage, it causes heavy exhaust smoke due to the burning of lubricating oil partially or fully. So when the oil, when the partially burning or fully burning, and also forms deposit on the piston crown and the exhaust port, which affect the engine efficiency. So sometimes the oil is also, lubricating oil is also burning partially or fully, and also because of the burning, they form the deposit on the piston crown, top of the piston, and the exhaust port, which affects the engine efficiency. Since the oil comes in close contact with the acidic vapor produced during the combustion process, the bearing surfaces may be corroded. So the oil, the oil is also in contact with the acidic vapor produced during the combustion process, so which will corrode the surface. The system calls for a thorough mixing of effective lubrication. So, the lubricating oil should thoroughly mixed with the air and the fuel, then only the lubrication will be effective. So, during the closed throttle operation, as in the case of vehicle moving down the hill, the engine will suffer insufficient lubrication. When you are moving in a downward direction, so the acceleration, we give lesser acceleration, the vehicle will move due to gravity, we give lesser acceleration. So, this is the almost closed throttle operation. So, during that period, the amount of air and fuel supplied to the engine is less. So, lubricating oil quantity is also less, so that there will be insufficient lubrication as the supply of fuel is less. So, this is an important limitation of the system. So, there are three drawbacks. There is a possibility of the lubricating oil burning along with the fuel that gives the deposits on the exhaust port and the piston crown. So, and the efficiency of the engine is also reducing. The oil is coming in contact with the combustion gases, which will corrode the surface. The system calls for thorough mixing of effective lubrication, and in the downhill operation, when the vehicle is moving down the hill, so it will suffer from the insufficient lubrication. So, these are all drawbacks, but however, this is used in the low capacity mopeds. So, which is because in that low capacity moped, due to crankcase compression, storing the oil in the crankcase is not possible. So, we have the crankcase compression. So, we have to mix the lubricating oil along with the fuel. And the wet sump lubrication system. In the wet sump lubrication system, the bottom of the crankcase, so engine cylinder, below the engine cylinder block, we have the crankcase. So, the bottom of the crankcase contains an oil pan, and this oil pan or sump. Which the lubricating oil is pumped to the various engine components. So, we are using the crankcase as the oil pan or a sump where the lubricating oil is stored, and from the crankcase, the lubricating oil is circulated to various engine components and it is collected back to the crankcase. After lubricating these parts, the oil will flow back to the sump by gravity. Again, it is picked up by a pump and recirculated through the engine lubricating system after proper filtering. So, in any 4-stroke cycle engine or a higher capacity engine, we have a crankcase where we are storing the lubricating oil. So, from the crankcase, the lubricating oil is circulated to various engine components. So, they are for lubrication purpose. After lubricating, the oil will fall back to the crankcase due to gravity, and the oil will be filtered, recirculated back to the lubrication system. That is what the wet sump lubrication system. And in the wet sump lubrication system, there are basic components in the system. One is pump, strainer, pressure regulator, filter, and breather. And these are all the components used in the wet sump lubrication system. This is the crankcase of the engine, so where we are storing the oil, and we have the oil strainer. So, the oil strainer will remove the dust particle from the oil, and we have a oil pump, gear oil pump. We are using the gear oil pump. The gear oil pump will raise the pressure of the oil so that the oil will be circulated with the pressure, and the oil will go to the engine bearing, and it will go to the filter. So, from here, this goes to filter and fall back to the engine crankcase. So, here we have a pressure relief valve. When the pressure is more, when the pump is creating more pressure, so it will release the pressure and the excess oil will go back to the pump input once again, recirculated back to the pump. So, from here, from the pump, the oil is going to various engine components. And here we have the breather, so it is open to atmosphere, and the oil pressure here is atmospheric pressure. So, the pressure in the crankcase, it will be atmospheric pressure. So, it is open to the atmosphere. Now, there are three varieties of wet sump lubrication system. One is splash system, second is the splash and the pressure system, and third is the pressure feed system. Simply a splash system, second splash and pressure system, and third one is pressure feed system. So, we take the first system, splash system. So, look at the diagram for a few seconds. we have the crankshaft. So we have the end bearing of the main bearing of the crankshaft, and this is what the connecting rod. So this is the first crank web, and we have a connecting rod. This is the big end of the connecting rod, and the small end of the connecting rod. The small end of the connecting rod is connected with the piston, and we have the other crank webs, and here we have the timing gear for valve actuating mechanism, and this is the camshaft. So the camshaft and the crankshaft, they are connected by the timing gear, where we have the cam which will actuate the valves. And here at the bottom we have the oil tray, and we have oil stainer, oil pump. The oil will come to the oil tray, oil actually lower oil pan. So this is the oil pan, and this is the oil trays. So we have oil tray, oil, the oil are stored here. We circulate the oil to the oil tray. And in the connecting rod, the big end of the connecting rod, at the end of the big end we have a scoop. We have a small projection, this is called a scoop. When the engine is running, when the crankshaft is rotating, the big end of the connecting rod, the scoop will dip into the oil tray, dip into the oil, and it will splash the oil to the entire component. So when the engine is running at a higher speed, so the scoop will continuously fall on the oil tray, continuously spray the oil. The oil will go, lubricated oil will go to the camshaft. Here the lower part of the piston up to this small end of the connecting rod and the camshaft, and here we have the main bearing and the big end of the connecting rod. So all the part, big end of the connecting rod, small end of the connecting rod, camshaft, crankshaft, all these parts are lubricated by spraying the lubricating oil using the scoop available at the end of the big end of the connecting rod. So this is called as splash lubrication system, and the pressure of the oil in the oil tray, it is maintained here. So the oil pressure gauge will be available in the dashboard. If suppose there is a fall in the oil pressure value, so we have to refill the oil, and we have to monitor the pressure gauge. Actually the oil pressure we have to sufficiently maintain. So if you find the oil, low oil pressure, then you have to refill with the lubricating oil. So this is what the splash lubrication system. So this is lubricating certain part. So there are some drawbacks. So the valve actuating mechanism, the exhaust valve, intake valve actuating mechanism, it is very difficult to lubricate using this method. So for that, we have the next method. So next method is the splash and the pressure lubricating system. So the splash is available, the oil tray is available, every component is available. In addition to that, we have a pressure line. So we have the pressure line, the lubricating oil is taken to the top using the pressure line. So using this pressure line, we are lubricating the camshaft, and this pressure line, the oil from here, it is taken to the valve actuating mechanism. So in the, suppose you have the valve actuating mechanism, overhead valve actuating mechanism, so in that case, we can use this method. So the oil under pressure, it will go to the valve actuating mechanism for lubricating the part. So this is the splash and the pressure lubrication system. So here again we have the pressure gauge to monitor the pressure of the lubricating oil. When the pressure decreases, we have to fill the crankcase with excess amount of lubricating oil. So it is combined with splash and the pressure. That is why it is called as splash and the pressure lubricating system. And it is completely pressure lubricating system. So we have the pressure line of the oil. So here we have the pressure line of the oil. So this is called as header line. So from the header line, the lubricating oil is circulated to various parts using the pipeline. So here you look at the gear. So it is taken to the bearing here. From here it is taken to the other bearing. So there are pipeline inside the crank web. So through the small opening, so the oil is flowing, which will lubricate the component. So here again the oil will flow, and here we take through the pipeline to the camshaft, and similarly to the valve actuating mechanism, we take the high pressure oil through a thin pipeline, a small diameter pipeline, so which will lubricate the various components in the engine, internal combustion engine. So pressure lubrication system. So the diagrams are very much similar. Similar diagram you have to draw, except the splash we have a scoop. So here again we have a scoop. So here there is no scoop, but it is completely by pressure feed system, we are using the circulation of the lubricating oil to various engine components wherever it is required. And a dry sump lubrication system. So, it is another type of the lubricating system where the oil sump is always dry. So, when the oil actually the cooling, the system is working with the same principle, but the sump is dry. When the oil, lubricating oil, after lubricating various parts, when it is falling on the sump, so actually the through the strainer, immediately the oil will go to the scavenging pump. So, filter and then pressure relief valve, then from the filter it goes to the supply tank. So, whenever the oil falls on the sump here, dry sump here, so the oil is immediately taken to the supply tank, and from the supply tank the oil is supplied to the various components. So, the sump is always dry. So, we actually, that is why it is called a dry sump lubricating system, and the oil is taken, filtered and taken to the supply tank. From the supply tank, it is supplied to various engine components for lubrication purpose. Once again, we have a cooler and oil pump. So, here there are additional components like a scavenging pump and the cooler supply tank. These are all the additional components in the dry sump lubrication system. And here we have two types of pumps. One is scavenging pump, which will remove the oil from the dry sump, and another one is oil pump, which is pressurizing the fuel to supply to the various engine components. So, this is what the dry sump lubrication system. So, the next topic is properties of lubricants. So, the fluid what we are using for lubrication purpose, it is called as lubricant. The duties of lubricant in an engine are many and varied in this scope. So, there are many functions for the lubricants. The lubricant is called upon to limit and control the following: friction between the component, metal to metal contact, everything is reduced, metal to metal contact is reduced, overheating of the component is reduced, wear of the component is reduced, corrosion is reduced, deposit formation is reduced. So, all these functions the lubricant has to perform, all these functions. So, friction between the component, metal to metal contact, actually when you have relative motion between two metal surfaces, a thin film of lubricant is available in between them. That is what the lubrication. So, overheating of component is reduced by the lubrication, wear of the component is reduced by the lubrication, corrosion deposits are reduced by the lubrication system in the IC engine. So, the lubricant what we are using should have certain properties. So, the required properties of lubricants: suitable viscosity. It should not be high viscous or low viscous. It should have suitable viscosity. So, the oilness. So, it should have some oilness. Oilness to ensure adherence to the bearing and for less friction and wear. When the lubrication is in boundary region as a protective covering against the corrosion. So, we require oilness to ensure adherence to the bearing and for lesser friction and wear when the lubrication is the boundary region, and also for protective cover. So, when oilness will ensure the adherence of the lubricant onto the surface. So, it will act as a protective covering against the corrosion, and it will reduce the friction and the wear from the surface. So, the adherence of the oil to the surface, it is given by the oilness of the lubricating oil. So, oilness is the next property. High strength to prevent metal to metal contact and seizure when under heavy load. So, there should be a small, always when there is a metal to metal contact between the two surfaces, there will be a small micron level gap. The micron level gap is filled by the lubricating oil. So, it requires the high strength to prevent the metal to metal contact and seizure when under heavy load. Should not react with the lubricating surface. So, it should not react with the metal surfaces. A low pour point. So, the pour point of the lubricant should be low, because when you have a low pour point, it will flow freely at low temperature. So, a low pour point to allow the flow of the lubricant at low temperature to the oil pump. No tendency to form deposit by uniting with the air. So, it should not react with the air, water, fuel or product of combustion. It should be chemically inert. The oil should be chemically inert, and it should not react with the air, water, fuel or product of combustion to form the deposit. So cleaning ability. So one function what we told, cleaning of the surfaces. So it should have the cleaning ability. The oil should have the cleaning ability. Non-forming characteristics. So it should not form, non-forming, should not forming with the on the surfaces. Non-toxic and non-flammable. So non-toxic, it should not be irritate the persons, or the it should not easily catch fire, non-flammable, and it should be available at a low cost. So these are all the desirable properties of a lubricants used in the IC engine. And we require certain characteristics, oiliness, strength, viscosity. So all the properties are available, but sometimes we are adding some additives to the lubricant to improve certain properties. The modern lubricant for heavy duty engines are highly refined which otherwise may produce sludge or suffer a progressive increase of viscosity. The viscosity of the oil will increase as the engine is running, when you use the oil for a longer time, the viscosity will increase. So we have to add some additives to maintain the viscosity. So for these reasons, the lubricants are tempered and seasoned by addition of certain oil soluble organic compound containing inorganic elements such as phosphorus, sulfur, amine derivatives. Metals are added to the mineral based lubricating oil to exhibit certain properties. So we add something phosphorus, sulfur, amine derivative, and sometimes metals are also added to increase certain properties of the lubricant. So the additives, that's the oil soluble organic compound added to the present lubricants to impart one or more of the following characteristics: antioxidant and anti-corrosive agent. So we have antioxidant, anti-corrosive agent, detergent agent, extreme pressure additives, pour point depressors. So this is used for reducing the pour point of the oil. Viscosity index improver. This will maintain the viscosity of the oil. Anti-foam agent, oilness and film strength agent. So it will improve the oilness and the film strength of the lubricating oil. So these are all the different, for improving these characteristics, we are adding certain additives. So we stop here. So we have a reflection point to answer few questions from the lecture. So you take a few seconds to relax and answer the question. The first question, name the primary and secondary functions of lubricating system. So the primary function is to reduce the friction and the wear. The secondary functions are to act as a sealing system, to cool and to clean. So to act as a cooling of engine components and to clean the dust particles or impurities from the surfaces, carbon deposits from the surfaces. Name different lubrication system: mist lubricating system, wet sump lubrication system, dry sump lubrication system. In the wet sump lubrication system, splash lubrication system, splash and the pressure lubrication system, and the pressure feed lubrication system. Name few properties of the lubricants: viscosity, oilness, film strength, pour point, low pour point, high film strength, and non-corrosive, non-forming, non-flammable. So like that, there are many properties of lubricants. Mist lubrication is used where the crankless lubrication is not possible. So in the mist lubrication, we are mixing the lubricating oil along with the fuel. So where the crankless lubrication is not possible, we are using the mist lubrication. The answer is true. And these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can collect it and use it for additional information. You can refer to other books I have mentioned for additional information. So thank you for watching. So please post your comments on the comments box of the YouTube video for improvement, and subscribe the YouTube channel. So I have uploaded more than 200 videos on thermal engineering subject, like engineering thermodynamics, heat and mass transfer, thermal engineering 1, thermal engineering 2, and also I have uploaded the solution for the gate questions. It will be useful for your learning and passing the gate examination. and you can write to me mail ID for any clarification or WhatsApp to my number. I will sincerely answer all your queries. Thank you for watching, and we will meet again.